Cat to y'all, cause I went there when they ain't had a ball. He tough as body. Wonder how he felt watching his dog cast the ball. I had to tell my YG stop. He don't like to pass the ball. That ticket, he talking big hit. I was kicking in houses for it. That's two different tickets, right? Oh, yeah, they loud, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be couching, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the thousand, boy. They get you touch and they get you foul, boy. I'm talking you out of bounds, boy. They always screaming, reach be snapping. I say the collar, boy. I'ma lose the roof and the stain. Please don't test me like on that boy, Jenny. And they talking games. It's like everything look cut them jaw. They go insane, they want a pitch. Ain't gon' get in the beef. I'ma just make them blitz. Round four deep in the sprinter. How that's your girl, and she in my rental. We had cable, we ain't even have no tunnels. They changed the channel and they see me. I'm signing deals and not no plea. Burglary, B&E. Don't you size me like no rapper. I be quick to grab my ski. That's my sweet, but I be switching it depending on the week. Christian Lou, red bottom, them I think I cut my feet. They talking about making industry music. They want me to count to y'all, but ain't gon' count to y'all. Cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty. Wonder how he felt watching his dog cast the ball. I had to tell my YG stop. He don't like to pass the ball. I wonder where that low is at. It was me against the wall. I was out here running plays. Guess it paid off after all. 613, bad girl. Her hat just got a star. She got it stitched and I got it stitches. We won't be sparing you. Chasing who? Pursuing who? I won't be chasing you. I'm 4-1, I lost the count. I'ma charge it to the game. 438 is not a game. It's just a music thing. Last player got out his lane. I'ma sit that pat when I get to Cali. Hope it gets sent back over. Rain in your range, ain't send no players. All I'm getting ran over. Don't spare mine, gon' spare yours. When I doing this game over. Only been rapping for like 4 months. Now they play a time over. They talking about making industry music. They want me to count to y'all, but ain't gon' count to y'all. Cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty. Wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop. He don't like to pass the ball.
Tables and turns.
Forget the bridges we done built. This time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Oh,
they count me out.
Nah, nah.
It all begins.
Right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can.
Total catch up.
But I still can't even see them from the view. Got my check up. And now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud of shoot.
And all designer drip get what I desire.
Put him out.
What I told him, cause that boy, he on fire.
Get that thing and air it up. Been in my bag a little bit.
Remember my pockets in a jar. I couldn't build a little chick.
They say that truly left his paper.
You see that's some milk.
Why you catch all my brothers ballin'. Ain't shooting no bricks.
Hold up, check me out.
I think the tables and turn.
Forget the bridges we done built. This time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Oh,
they count me out.
Nah, nah.
It all begins.
Right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can.
Well, it may be a bit soggy, but that certainly hasn't deterred this fan base. A great crowd on hand to battle the raindrops at Nissan Stadium in Nashville. This crowd here fired up for football as a moment ago their Titans were introduced. This should be a good one as the Titans get set to match up with the Denver Broncos. Set to go now on a wet and rainy night, and off we go from Nashville. Fielded just outside the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. They run for the first time with Javonte Williams. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Now a first down carry. It's Williams. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us, need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed, but they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I'm looking at this one with my defensive eyeglasses on because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be 3rd and less than a yard.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Stewart. This one swung out to Williams. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and it'll be 2nd down. Out of the pistol, here's Williams. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
That catch good for only a couple. Stewart sets to throw. This is Hamler on the receiving end. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans' 13-yard line.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
No gain on the play there. 2nd down.
All right, quick observation, Brandon, because early on in this game, I'm seeing linebackers playing with their noses close to the line of scrimmage.
And my guess is the wheels are turning on that other sideline. As a play caller, you're filing that away right now, aren't you?
Yeah, you're trying to find that opportunity later on when you can play action them or stick something to them between the 2nd and the 3rd level.
It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's 3rd down. Stewart. And this is caught by Sutton. Touchdown, Broncos. Cortland Sutton hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Broncos take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is Tony Pollard. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. This is Jonathan Taylor. Oh, what a move. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. To the right side, this is Taylor. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
Defensively here, you're facing a top-5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high-powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20-point score, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A big play that time on the catch and run. So a 1st and 10 now in Denver territory, down at the 33. Now a handoff, Taylor with it. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. They give it off here to the tight end. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this 1st quarter. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on 2nd down. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Snags it for the pick, and the Broncos are going to take over at their own 2-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
And he's able to get this across the 10 before being taken down.
Well, so much for being backed up against their goal line to start the drive. He gave some breathing room and then some. I think the defense really got caught thinking safety, trying to stack the line of scrimmage. And oftentimes, if you can get past the initial grouping, there's a lot of room to run.
And he's going to be brought down. Back in his own 6-yard line. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up 2nd. Here's Stewart to throw it. He'll go up top here for Hamler. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be 3rd down. And Charles, got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on 1st down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back, but it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Stewart. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. picked off by Amari Hooker, and he'll bring it back to the 9-yard line. CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, ah, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. He'll drop to throw. Well, a diving effort right sideline. He's got it. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. It'll be a loss of two on the play. And that's going to bring up an interesting third and goal. He'll look to throw. Toward the pylon, caught. Touchdown. A great effort there. With a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point splits the uprights, and we are tied here in the second quarter. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Second and 10. Off the bootleg, Stewart. That's complete, Okwue Bunam. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. They'll try and run for it. Here's Williams. And he's going to have a Broncos first down as good running gets him to about the 44. You talked about the need for them to establish the run early. They've been able to do that here in the first half.
And that means that the whole offense has adopted that attitude and that persona. We're going to take care of this young quarterback. Let's all get together and run it and take the pressure off.
They stick to the ground game on first down. It's Williams. And he's got room. The 20. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Javonte Williams with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Broncos have taken the lead.
Sometimes running plays hit or break so fast, there's no reaction time from the secondary. So I've got to give credit to the offensive line for creating that hole so suddenly. And how decisive was he to take that cut and just go? No one downfield there to stop him.
Extra point by McCann, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. From just inside the 20, a short kick. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. It's caught inside the 25. And it's a Titans touchdown. A big play there. His 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Vedvik now for the extra point. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides of this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
Here's 2nd and 10. Gonna go play action. Here's Stewart. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up 3rd down. The Broncos on 3rd down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Back to throw. Stewart. He'll go up top here for Hamler. A fight for the football, and it's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it, and the Titans force the turnover. They'll take over at their own 27. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes it all the way down to the 28-yard line. A big play that time for the Titans. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Now a throw here, hauled in, and he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Here's 2nd and 9, just 1 yard on that last run. Nifty move, and he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. Nickel set defensively for the Broncos here on 3rd down. In your face. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. They'll look to run with Taylor. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Jonathan Taylor, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Titans are going to take the lead. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is now 21-14. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a golden opportunity.
And it looked like he got the feet down, did he? Yes, it's a catch. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21. A huge play there for Denver. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. From the gun, it's a run for Williams. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Looking to throw. Stewart, open man, Hamler, that's complete. So the pitch and catch good for 11. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. Throwing out of the shotgun, it's Stewart. Got a man, it's Judy, complete. And the Broncos are going to be set up with a first and goal as they get the conversion there on third and inches. Now the Broncos will use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. Back to throw. Stewart. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
He was looking for Albert O. Albert Okwuegbunam was the target there, but it'll be second and goal. To throw again, and the pass is caught. Touchdown Denver. Jerry Jeudy, as the first half is winding down, and the Broncos have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. McCann now for the extra point. He's got it, and we're all tied at 21. A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. Now Pollard. And he's going to get this across the 20 as he's out of bounds at the 23. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together. He'll rifle this one deep right side. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. Right hash, 37-yard attempt. And his kick is right there. It's good. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we'll send you down to Orlando. We check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. Now Pollard. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25. Titans offense set to begin the drive. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half it didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime. I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available, because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And this is caught inside the five. A big play that time for the Titans. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most often...
And he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. Jonathan Taylor, his second touchdown of the night. And the Titans take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. On for the point after, Corey Vedvik. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Goes onto the field ready to start their next drive. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
Now he dumps this off over the middle and able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game.
That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up a first down.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man, and you got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Third quarter on a Monday night with a second and 10 coming up. From the shotgun, a give to Jones. And he's up over midfield and down into Tennessee territory. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Off the play fake, here's Cordell Stewart. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. It's a big play there for the Broncos. So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And a short pickup there down to about the 9. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Operating from the gun, Stewart. Quick hitter here, it's complete. Only 3 yards on the catch, it's third down. Looking to throw, Stewart going right back to Fant. Good defense holds him to only a yard and it'll be fourth down.
Hey, let's face it, you can put any Halloween costume on him. You're not going to be able to disguise him because for a tight end of his size, difficult to sneak him anywhere, but that's what they tried to do. Lined up on his right, tried to work his way back to his left, but just a minimal gain as the defense was able to react quickly.
McCann's kick is good, and this is back down to a 7-point game. So the response to that touchdown on the other side to begin the third quarter. Look, just 3 points, but still a response nonetheless.
You're exactly right about that because I think you needed to answer back with something, even though it's not 6. Just enough to send the message that says, hey, we're not going away.
From just inside the 20, a short kick. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And we have seen a lot on the scoreboard here in this quarter. So sometimes you talk to me about tendency breakers on offense. These defenses struggling. Are there tendency breakers on defense?
All defensive coordinators keep something in their hip pocket for these types of situations. What can we do to slow down the onslaught? But the biggest thing is make sure these guys encourage each other, pick themselves up, because right now, it's been a really tough ball game trying to stop these offenses.
Oh, it really has, especially as of late. Back to Taylor on first down. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. So, Charles, you talk about this head coach, and let's face it, this season certainly has not gone the way many had expected or at least hoped. And I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier this week.
Yeah, we certainly did, didn't we? Because, let's face it, he's heard the whispers, and they're growing louder that he shouldn't be around next year. He essentially stormed out of that meeting you just referenced with the reporters. How did he end it? We're done here. Well, that's a function of losing and all the pressure that's on him. You hear about pressure creating diamonds? In this case, it's bursting the pipes of the coach.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. A give for Taylor running right side, powering his way forward. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 62 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 38. They'll run the toss here to Taylor. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. First down run, got five. Here's second and five. Now a give, right side. It's Taylor. Taylor's got the first down and more. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Jonathan Taylor, his third touchdown of the game, number 11 on the year. And the Titans add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. Extra point try now for Vedvik. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded just outside the goal line. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it
down. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off near the 26. Boy, so another interception, CD. It feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
An opening there on that first down run as he gets this forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so 2nd and 2. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. Pollard going to try the right side. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. For Pollard. They have pretty good pursuit there defensively. He's brought down, no gain on the play. 2nd down coming up. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the 4th quarter. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. The Titans on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This will be third and 19. On play action, they'll throw. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Their defense was able to force the punt. That's the good news. But this is still a two-score game, and they need points on this drive and in a relatively quick manner. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. From the gun, it's Stewart. Got a man over the middle. It's Williams. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on first and 10. Back to throw. Stewart. Oh, he'll air this one deep for Judy. And this is going to fall to the ground, incomplete. That very nearly their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now it's the backup, Tannehill. Again, he targets Judy, and this time the catch made. So two first downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, first and 10. To the air again, Tannehill. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. So operating from Tennessee territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. He'll go up top here for Hamler. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. If they had designs of kind of wiggling their way back into this one, that hurts their chances right there.
Man, to put it mildly, look at the lead, look at the deficit, trying to make a play downfield. Everyone seeking to be somewhat the hero. Didn't turn out that way at all, and you're exactly right. It's going to take a lot for them to have a chance to win.
And now off to the races, down the right side. He's at the 40, 20, 10, 5, touchdown Titans. A.J. Brown, 94 yards. And the Titans are closing in on win number 10 as they extend this fourth quarter lead. Vedvik now for the extra point. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21 points. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And 3 interceptions in this game, and I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, what's interesting is what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Now this will go for five up to the 33. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. They run it again with Williams. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a 10th carry. Here's Williams. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Looking to throw, Stewart. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he's going to drop this off to Williams. Complete. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive. Eighth play of the drive forthcoming, and they need 8 yards on third down. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Now the Broncos will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. Now Stewart on first and 10. He's got his big tight end, Fant. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. And the Titans come up with a late turnover. But it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feeling like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offense...
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling.
touchdown. I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's
them gala red eye, never make right. Me, they are suffer life, them I get by. Never bow for the fame, no? Heads high. Never come me so all them I see a tear light. Been a real from the ghetto. I ain't never gon' switch, that's facts though. Can't get me out like steel. I'ma grow tough, I'ma know pain. Here, toss talk with a bad tongue. Can't break me, twiddle be so dumb. I'ma be a giant thief, 5-4 from doing it so big like Drake, I'm on one. My big box got me feeling so bossy like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called.
Only religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling.
My big box got me feeling so bossy like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty, cause if my too loyal, then it's gonna cost me. And
that's just how I feel.
Yeah.
That's just how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, Rick Ross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Don't you ever get it crisscross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscross. Bet against me, that's a big love. You about to find out what the cow. I find, then I get low. Lift up.